Teen. How's everybody doing today?
I'm all right.
Oh, yeah, it's been okay.
Hey, you forgot.
We don't have everything still. We're missing one. I think it's kind of true. Yeah, Hunter.
Hey,
Hunter.
We have like 1.1 and then we have like
2.2.
Yep. I have Hunter's. So we add 1.4 to both sides. If you're missing this and it seems like we're doing this out of nowhere, it's because you were talking or paying close enough attention. Please stop talking. I asked you briefly how you were doing. It should take 2 seconds, and then we're done. Okay, so we add 1.4. The logic there is that negative 1.4 plus 1.4 is
zero.
So we have n plus nothing, which is the same as
x
n.
Equal.
Yeah, x or n.
Equals.
Okay, here we have negative 6.3. Where is negative 6.3?
To the left.
To the left.
To the left.
We good?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna add 1.4. What does it look like to add 1.4 around the number line?
Positive.
Right. Well, that's misleading. We're adding 1.4, and that gets us to here, which is
4.9.
Negative 4.9. N equals negative 4.9.
Yeah.
And so does N plus 0.
Both equal negative 4.9.
Okay, that's 15. Next question. Cool.
Could you do the bowling pin one?
Sure. I think that was 17.
That was really confusing.
Yeah.
That was really confusing.
Nobody bowls?
It would be confusing if you know how to bowl.
I bowl. I don't bowl.
It would be less confusing if you knew how to bowl.
I don't know how to bowl. So this is what the last two frames and the final score of this game that you played with your friend, bowling, okay? So what you see up here in the top or in the top right corner of each frame is what you did in that frame, okay? So you know how bowling works? Basically, you get up there, you get your ball, you throw it down there. If you don't knock down all the pins, you get a second chance to do that. Okay, so here's your first chance and your second chance. First chance, second chance. For example, this is you. You knock down 6. There are still 4 standing. You knock down 3 of those 4, and 1 was left, and, well, you only get 2 tries in that frame.
Yeah.
This person knocked down 8, and then what happened?
Spare.
Nothing. They didn't get any. Whether it's a gutter ball or they just kind of went past the pins they were trying to knock down. What does this symbol mean?
Spare.
That means spare. So they knock down 7, then they knock down 3, and in the 10th frame, when you do that, when you knock down all of the pins, you get another try. Okay. If you were to get a strike, if you were to knock them all down in one try, you get another try, and another try. You get a maximum of 3 throws. As long as you keep knocking down all the pins, you get as many as 3 tries. Okay? So this person had 89, right? They got 8, and they added 8 to their previous score. Now they're at 89. Then they knock down 7, then 3 more, that's 10. And then they knock down 6 more, right? So they got 16 in this frame. Okay? Which takes us to 105. You are over here. You bowled a 6, and then you knock down 3 more. So your score after that is 82, right? We had a score before. Bowled 6 pins, knocked down 3 pins additional, and we're at 82. Okay? So far, what we know, in the 10th frame, you have knocked down 9 pins on your first try. Okay? And apparently, you lost count. I don't know what happened, but for some reason, you know what your final score is. Okay? Your final score, it says in here, not even part A, before that, it says, your final bowling score is 14 pins less than your friend's final score. So, what does it say? Write and solve an equation to find your final score. Pretty simple equation. You're going to write and solve. I don't want you to just figure out what your final score is. I want you to write an equation that you can solve. Right? I'm trying to think with an algebra brain. Jaden, so equation could you write?
You could do 105 minus 14 equals x.
Good. That's an equation. Pretty easy to solve, right? The only thing we'd have to do to solve is subtract 14 from 105. What does that give us?
Ninety-one.
Final score is 91.
Oh, wow.
We happen to know that the final score is 91. I'm not sure why we know that. Cool? Here's another equation. I could say my score plus 14 more pins would come up to my friend's score of 105. Okay. These are the same, of course, because how would I solve this equation?
14.
Subtract 14 from both sides, so I get x equals 105 minus 14, which is what that says already. So the next question is, your friend made a spare right there. They knocked down 7, knocked down the remaining 3. That's why they got to try a third time. Did you make a spare in this final frame?
No.
How do you know?
Because.
Cool?
Because there's not the little slash things, marks in the boxes.
Let's kind of imagine, like, maybe it might have been, but whoever forgot to write down those marks. Jaden?
Because if you add it all together, it equals 91.
Add what together?
Eighty-two plus 9.
The 9 in the next frame is already at 91.
Yeah.
So if I were gotten a spare, that means I got at least one more pin, which would be 92 at the very least. So no, we didn't get a spare in the 10th frame. We just gutterballed it, missed, and then you don't get another try if you miss. So that's it. That's your 10th frame. Who bowls in here? Who knows how to score bowling?
I do
sometimes.
Bowling.
Oh,
you know how to score bowling?
What? Just look at the screen.
What?
Score
that's
bowling.
How you score.
I just look at the
screen. You score bowling. Yeah, we have to do that.
It's got some interesting rules for scoring, but we'll not take up your time explaining that because we want to move on. So there's the bowling one. Any more questions from the homework?
Nope.
Means that we're ready to put everything away and take a homework review. Is that true?
No.
Yeah.
So we have more questions?
No.
Then? No.
No.
Sid?
Go.
Do this.
So, obviously,
Sid's asking a question. Don't make a bunch of noise.
18 out of 10.
18? Okay.
All right, team, here it comes.
We want all the wrestling of the papers and the chit chat and all that kind of stuff to be quiet so we can all concentrate on what we're talking about here. And I will allow you to waste time making all this noise. And only once it's over will I begin. I won't count the show. Alright, 7 times x equals 35. And I want to know what x is worth. I don't know what 7 times x is worth. So, Marcus?
7
divided by 7 on both sides? You certainly can do that. You can do anything you want as long as it's on both sides. But let's think about.
So that's 1x.
Yeah, 7 divided by 7 is 1. 1 times x. And what's 1 times x?
X.
Good.
Yeah.
35 divided by 7 is 1. How do we make sure that we're correct? Marcus?
7 times 5.
Pulling it back in there. Pulling it right back in there. 7 times 5 is 35.
I think it'd be easier if you just rhymed it. I know it sounds like a cheesy thing to do, but 7 times 5 is 35 times.
Well, it ends in the same number. By that reasoning, everything that ends in a 5 and is multiplied by 5 is a rhyme. 6 times, or 5 times 5 is 25, that rhymes. 9 times 5 is 45, that rhymes. I understand what you're saying. I think I understand what you're saying. Like, I see it 7 times blank is 35.
Yeah.
And here's the thing that students have so much trouble doing, trusting their math teacher to do. The answer is obvious. So we don't learn a new thing. We resist the new thing and say, it's obvious what x is. But that's what we start with. We start with answers that are obvious. So that we can see that the new strategy that we're learning works. Okay? If I were to throw something at you that wasn't obvious, now you have an answer that's not obvious, and you're having to learn some new thing, like it's a bunch all at once. Okay? So to see that dividing by 7 works out to give you obviously what it must be, right? It helps us to gain confidence in, instead of just saying what the number must be, saying, here's what I'm going to do to isolate x. Okay? Because once an equation becomes complicated enough, we're going to want these strategies, and we're going to apply them just like one after the other, and whittle away at that problem. Okay? So yeah, I know it's kind of painful to do this extra little showing your work for something that's so obvious. Okay? But trust me, it's gonna come in handy if you take the time to learn it. All right. Does that mean we're ready to go?
Yeah.
Ready to clear our desks?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Take the positive 7 and negative 7.
Sometimes when you phrase it that way, I'm not sure what you mean.
Minus 7.
So we subtract 7. Why would subtracting 7 be the thing that I want to do?
So you can get to 0.
0, right? X plus 0, right? X plus 7 minus 7 is the same as 0.
Yeah, and X plus 0 is just X.
Right, so X is whatever we have
2.
Here, which is 2.
Yeah.
X is 2. Okay. Okay. Future reference, if there are questions while you're taking the homework review, there's not a lot of answers I'm going to give you. I'm going to treat it like it's a test. Okay, so if you had questions about this, then just remember these few things. Maybe just one thing. Even if you don't get the right answer, or you struggle with a question, that's what this time is for, is to see what it is you know and what you don't, what you need to work on and what you have down, okay? Are you going to practice a bunch of those? Most of you probably not. It sounds like we're good with that. Maybe we want to practice some of these because we're having some trouble? Okay, now we know that. All right? Are you going to practice a bunch of these? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how you did. Okay? So, and even if you don't do very well, like if your score is not high on this, remember that all of these homework reviews, they all go together in one little pile, and that pile makes up just 5% of your grade. Okay? You don't want to get zeros on all of them, because if you just lost 5% of your grade, that'd be kind of a bummer. Okay? We get partial credit on the ones that we try, so as long as we're trying each day, like we're going to get most of that 5%. Okay. All right, so back to it. We have negative 3/4 plus x, which, if it helps to look at it this way, it's the same as x minus 3/4, x plus negative 3/4.
already done
too much for you.
Jaden?
All of it?
Yeah.
You would subtract 3 minus, or 3 over 4, minus 3 over 4. And then you do the same 5 over 6.
Subtract 3 fourths?
Yeah, and the regular 3 fourths would become 0.
What do you mean regular 3 fourths?
The 3 fourths you started with.
Well, we started with minus 3 fourths or negative 3 fourths.
Add, sorry.
So you would add?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then.
So that goes to 0, you're saying? You're already starting to say that.
And then you would take. Alright. When you would add 5 plus 3, which would be. Yeah, it'd be 8. You'd add 5 plus 2, it would be 8. And then you would add 6 plus 4, which would be 10. And then
8 tenths?
Wait.
I don't know.
No.
Okay. About 3 fourths is, Well, 3 fourths looks like this. And 5 sixths looks like this. Pretty big pieces of the pie, right? They're only like one piece away each from being a whole pie. So if we add them together, it seems like we get more than a whole pie. We get a whole pie and some more. But here we have less than a pie still. Right? That comes from trying to add two things together. Like, look at this. 5 of these sixths and 3 of these fourths. These sixths and these fourths, they're different. They're different from each other. How are they different from each other? They're not of oranges.
What?
How are these six and these fourths
one that's
literally different? What's that?
One's bigger.
One is bigger.
One kind of piece is bigger. This piece, this fourth piece, is bigger than a sixth.
Yeah, man.
So I can't add a fourth and a sixth. They're not the same. They're like apples and oranges. So they're different kinds of things. They're different sizes. So we can't add them together. In order to add these together, what would we need to do, Marcus?
Common denominator.
Common denominator. What did you use 12. For common denominator? 12?
So multiply.
Only Marcus would be making noise. I'm tapping a pencil, the talk is very distracting, and it's wasting our time. Marcus.
So 3 fourths times 3.
So multiply by
multiply
3 over 3.
And then 2.
2 over 2. We get 10 twelfths plus 9 twelfths is 19 twelfths.
1 and 7 twelfths.
So you got a common denominator of 24 instead?
Well, I got it right.
I got 24 and then I simplified that. So I got 112.
I got
1. Oh, you did that. If you multiply this by 4, you have to multiply this by 4, so it would be 20 24ths. You have to multiply this by 6 and this by 6, so it would be 18 24ths. So 20 plus 18 would be 38 24ths. Not 124ths. Oh, but it was negative here, so we want to add to cancel the negative. Add 3/4 to get to 0. Probably other than that, it would have worked. Matt, did you have something?
No.
Okay. And 5x equals 15. We're going to get x by itself. It's a lot like the question that Sydney brought up. Brandon?
5 divided by 5.
Divide by 5 on both sides. We get 5 divided by 5 is
1, which is just x. And then 5 divided by 3 is
5.
Oh! You just playing x.
That sounds like an excellent human
You play it.
It's just the Hunter's Fall.
Let's see. What do I have?
I told you to shut up.
How are you doing?
I do have, and I do play.
You do?
What do you play?
What do you play?
I bet
you play
college.
most
How
of GTA
old are you?
Right
yes!
Yeah!
Yeah!
But yeah. That is the bomb. He's the better teacher.
Wait, who
what?
Are you? I mean, how old are you?
33.
You're awesome.
Thank you.
I'm 33.
Do you have a YouTube channel?
Alright.
You should do math on GTA.
I want you to know my edge.
Shh. You didn't have your notes out. You should have your notes out now. You can give it a shot. We're going to do it together here in a second.
Okay.
Okay, so I know what Jaden's going to say, right? He's going to say some number divided by 4 is 7, so it's pretty clear that that number must be
28.
I can just see it. We're trying to graduate from being able to see it. Everybody can see it, all right? Everybody knows we're going to divide a number by 4 and get 7, so that number must be 28. We're going to graduate to a higher level of thinking while the answers are obvious, graduating when the answers are difficult. So let's use that, though. Let's use that to our advantage. You know that the number must be 28 because 7 times 4, right, is 28. Let's see the other side what's going on. Rather than just saying 7 times 4 is 28 being done because we have the answer now, and let's learn something about what's going on this side. 7 times 4 is 28. We know that's the right answer. Let's multiply this side by 4. So this is a fraction, x over 4, so let's put that 4 over 1 so we can see what's happening there. We multiply straight across 4 times x over 4 times 1. So it's kind of familiar, right? 4 divided by 4 is 1. 1x is 28. So x is 28. We knew in our gut, with our common sense, that the answer must be 28. Because this number must get divided by 4. And for the answer to be 7, that number would have to be 28. Right? So in your head, you went ahead and just multiplied 7 by 4 instinctively and got 28. Trying to show you what's going on over here, like why we can justify that algebraically. Okay? You can think of algebra as like the strategies that we use to isolate x, to figure out what x is worth. Okay? So when we multiply 7 times 4, we know the answer is right. We know 28 is correct. But if you look at what's happening over here when you multiply by 4, you end up with 4 over 4, which is 1x. So you can see that that's working out nicely on the left side. Okay? So that later, when it's not as obvious that we're just supposed to have the answer be 28, if I see, say, x over 3, you know, on one side of the equation, what am I going to do to both sides of the equation? Is this equal to 7? We'll multiply it by
3.
No matter what's over here, right? The reason we multiply it by 3 is because x is being divided by 3. So if this is 5, multiply by 3 on both sides, 3x over 3. Same as x, and 5 times 3 is 15. Alright, let's crank it up a notch. We were always going to crank it up a notch. 5/8 x equals 15. Remember the in the previous problem, and in other problems we've done, it was nice to wind up with 1 times x equals whatever. 5/8 times x doesn't tell me what x is. What x is, it's not far away. So I got 5/8 times x. Can anybody suggest something we could do to the left side of the equation that would result in a 1 times x instead of a 5/8 times x? Any ideas? Let's go back to the homework review had a question like this, 5x equals 15.
Oh, I got it.
Answer. I don't want to know what x is. I want to know what did we do to the equation to get to x.
I did it a weird way, but I still can't.
Okay, we're trying to strengthen our algebra skills in a way that we go from this somehow to 1 times x. Can you tell us how to do that? Not just tell us how to get the answer?
No.
Okay. I'm glad you got the answer, and that's great. But we want a strategy for like all equations. Okay. But what we
you did here. And 5x equals 15. Isn't this a number times x? This is a number times x. This is a number times x. Strategy wouldn't be a whole lot different, Sid.
Can you put a 1 under the 15?
You can. Does that help us with something?
Can you take the 5 8s times 15?
If I want to take 15 over 1 and multiply by 5 8s, then I'd have to multiply by 5 8s on both sides. Because this 5 8s is not being multiplied by 15. There's an equation, just an equal sign here.
Okay.
We can do anything we want, as long as we do it to both sides, right? As long as we do it to both sides, it stays balanced. So we can multiply both sides by 5 8s. Does multiplying by 5 8s make this equation any more simple? What's 5 8s times 5 8s?
Well,
now we have a different idea.
Wait, wouldn't it be divide instead of multiply?
Okay, it sounds like we're abandoning this multiply by 5 8s idea. That's fine. Instead, we're going to do what?
Divide.
Yeah.
By what?
5 8s.
What's 5 8s divided by 5 8s? Just like any number divided by itself.
No, 0.
1 times x. If it was 0, that's 0 times x. 0 times x is 0. That's
okay. And then you do that.
Then we have to do the same thing to both sides, so we divide by 5 8s.
And then the answer.
How do we divide by a fraction? Cole?
You could do it the other way, I guess.
The other way? What do you mean?
Never mind.
How do we divide by a fraction? Divide by the fraction 5 8s, James?
Would it be 3 eighths?
Watch this. Watch by multiply by 8/5 here. What's 5 8s times 8/5?
1.
It's 1, right? So the denominator is 1. We're dividing by 1, which so the answer would be whatever up here, but I can't just multiply the denominator by 8/5, I have to multiply
that by 8/5.
Numerator by 8/5.
Oh.
This is just 1. Whatever 15 over 1 times 8 over 5 is, that's going to be our final answer. Cole?
3 over 8.
3 over 8.
120.
Wait, what?
120 over 5, and then you reduce that.
120 over 5. 120 divided by 5?
24.
Oh,
I got it.
Or 5 and 15 have a factor of 5 in common. We get 3 there, 1 there. 3 times 8 is 24. Let's do it again. The same exact problem again. 5 8x equals 15.
Oh, okay.
But this time we'll look at it just slightly differently. Perfect. Divide by 5 8s on both sides. Great. But just keep in mind, when you divide by a fraction like 5 8s, you always wind up multiplying by the reciprocal 8/5. So, from the very beginning, how about if we do this instead? It's the same. It's the exact same. It's like equivalent to doing what you did there. But I think it's just a little more straightforward, a little more clean. So if you multiply this both sides by 8/5. Okay? What's 8/5 times 5 8s?
1.
40 over 40. 40 over 40, which is 1. And now we have 15 over 1 times 8 over 5. No coincidence, it's the same as what we see here. We could simplify this. 3 times 8 over 1 times 1 is 24. Not a surprise. Of course, it's the same answer. The answer is what the answer is. X is what it needs to be. Question cool?
Is that our homework?
That thing at the top, that bottom. This right here. All that. Yes.
What are you doing?
Oh my god.
This is what we call a two-step equation. I know how much time we have left. 3x plus 5 equals 7. First, we subtract 5. So we have 3x equals 2. Divide by 3. X equals 2/3. Okay, have a good day.